Projective Geometry, Volume 1, by Oswald, Veblen, and John Wesley Young.
Chapter 7, Coordinate Systems in 2 and 3 Dimensional Forms. Section 65, Pencils of Points and Lines, Projectivity. A convenient analytic representation of the points of a pencil of points, or the lines of a pencil of lines, is given by the following dual theorems. Theorem 5. Any point of a pencil of points may be represented by P equal to lambda 2 A1 plus lambda 1 B1, comma lambda 2 A2 plus lambda 1 B2, comma lambda 2 A3 plus lambda 1 B3, where A equal to A1 A2 A3 and B equal to B1 B2 B3 are any two distinct points of the pencil. Theorem 5 prime. Any line of a pencil of lines may be represented by P equal to mu 2 M1 plus mu 1 N1, comma mu 2 M2 plus mu 1 N2, comma mu 2 M3 plus mu 1 N3, where M equal to M1 M2 M3 and N equal to N1 N2 N3 are any two distinct lines of the pencil. Proof. We may confine ourselves to the proof of the theorem on the left. By theorem 4, corollary 2, any point x1, x2, x3 of the pencil of points on the line AB satisfies the relation. Equation 1. The 3x3 determinant, read by columns, x1, a1, b1, x2, a2, b2, x3, a3, b3 is equal to 0. We may then determine three numbers, rho, lambda 2 prime, lambda 1 prime, such that we have equation 2, rho x sub I equal to lambda 2 prime a sub I plus lambda 1 prime b sub I for I equal to 1, 2, and 3. The number rho cannot be 0 under the hypothesis, for then we should have from equation 2 the proportion a1 is to a2 is to a3 equal to b1 is to b2 is to b3, which would imply the points A and B coincide. We may, therefore, divide by rho. Denoting the ratios, lambda 2 prime divided by rho and lambda 1 prime divided by rho by lambda 2 and lambda 1, we see that every point of the pencil may be represented in the manner specified. Conversely, every point whose coordinates are of the form specified clearly satisfies relation 1 and is, therefore, a point of the pencil. The points A and B in the above representation are called the base points of this so-called parametric representation of the elements of a pencil of points. Evidently, any two distinct points may be chosen as base points in such a representation. The ratio lambda 1 divided by lambda 2 is called the parameter of the point it determines. It is here written in homogeneous form, which gives the point A for the value lambda 1 equals 0, and the point B for the value lambda 2 equals 0. In many cases, however, it is more convenient to write this parameter in non-homogeneous form. P equal to A1 plus lambda B1, comma A2 plus lambda B2, comma A3 plus lambda B3, which is obtained from the preceding by dividing by lambda 2 and replacing lambda 1 divided by lambda 2 by lambda. In this representation, the point B corresponds to the value lambda equal infinity. We may also speak of any point of the pencil under this representation as the point, the ratio lambda 1 to lambda 2, or the point lambda when it corresponds to the value lambda 1 divided by lambda 2 equal lambda of the parameter. Similar remarks and the corresponding terminology apply, of course, to the parametric representation of the lines of a flat pencil. It is sometimes convenient, moreover, to adopt the notation A plus lambda B to denote any point of the pencil whose base points are A, B, or to denote the pencil itself. Also, to use the notation M plus mu N to denote the pencil of lines or any line of this pencil whose base lines are M and N. In order to derive an analytic representation of a projectivity between 2 one-dimensional primitive forms in the plane, we seek first the condition that the point lambda of a pencil of points A plus lambda B be on the line mu of a pencil of lines M plus mu n. by Theorem 3 the condition that the point lambda be on the line mu is the relation summation from I equal 1 to I equal 3 of the quantity m sub I plus mu n sub I times the quantity a sub I plus lambda b sub I equal 0. When expanded, this relation gives mu lambda summation I equal 1 to 3 n sub I b sub I plus mu times summation from I equal 1 to 3 n sub I a sub I plus lambda times summation from I equal 1 to 3 m sub I b sub I plus summation from I equal 1 to 3 m sub I a sub I equal to 0. This is a bilinear equation whose coefficients depend only on the coordinates of the base points and the base lines of the two pencils and not on the individual points for which the condition is sought. Placing summation n sub I b sub I equal to c, summation n sub I a sub I equal to d, summation m sub I b sub I equal to negative a, summation m sub I a sub I equal to negative b, the equation becomes c mu lambda plus d mu minus a lambda minus b equals 0, which may be written, equation 1, mu equal to the quantity a lambda plus b divided by the quantity c lambda plus d. The result may be stated as follows. Any perspective relation between two one-dimensional primitive forms of different kinds is obtained by establishing a projective correspondence between the parameters of the two forms. Since any projective correspondence between two one-dimensional primitive forms is obtained as the resultant of a sequence of such perspectivities, and since the resultant of any two linear fractional transformations of type 1 is a transformation of the same type, we have the following theorem. Footnote, the determinant ACBD does not vanish because the correspondence between lambda and mu is 1, 1. Theorem 6. Any projective correspondence between two one-dimensional primitive forms in the plane is obtained by establishing a projective relation, mu equal to the quantity alpha lambda plus beta divided by the quantity gamma lambda plus delta, where alpha delta minus beta gamma is not equal to 0, between the parameters mu lambda of the two forms. In particular, we have Corollary 1. Any projectivity in a one-dimensional primitive form in the plane is given by the relation of the form lambda prime is equal to the quantity alpha lambda plus beta divided by the quantity gamma lambda plus delta, with alpha delta minus beta gamma not equal to 0, where lambda is the parameter of the form. Corollary 2. If lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda 3, lambda 4 are the parameters of four elements, a sub 1, a sub 2, a sub 3, a sub 4 of a one-dimensional primitive form, the cross ratio R of a1, a2, comma a3, a4 is given by R of a1, a2, comma a3, a4 is equal to R of lambda 1, lambda 2, comma lambda 3, lambda 4, which is equal to the quantity lambda 1 minus lambda 3 divided by the quantity lambda 1 minus lambda 4, colon lambda 2 minus lambda 3 divided by lambda 2 minus lambda 4. A projectivity between two different one-dimensional forms may be represented in a particularly simple form by a judicious choice of the base elements of the parametric representation. To fix ideas, let us take the case of two projective pencils of points. Choose any two distinct points, A, B, of the first pencil to be the base points, and let the homologous points of the second pencil be base points of the latter. Then, to the values lambda equals 0 and lambda equal infinity of the first pencil must correspond the values mu equals 0 and mu equal infinity, respectively, of the second. In this case, the relation of Theorem 6, however, assumes the form mu equal to k times lambda. Hence, since the same argument applies to any distinct forms, we have Corollary 3. If two distinct projective one-dimensional primitive forms in the plane are represented parametrically so that the base elements form two homologous pairs, the projectivity is represented by a relation of the form mu equals k lambda between the parameters mu lambda of the two forms. This relation may be still further simplified. taking again the case discussed above of the two projective pencils of points, we have seen that, in general, the point A1 plus B1, A2 plus B2, A3 plus B3, i.e. 2 lambda equal 1 corresponds the point A1 prime plus KB1 prime, A2 prime plus KB2 prime, A3 prime plus KB3 prime, i.e. the point mu equal K. Since the point B prime equal to B1 prime, B2 prime, B3 prime is also represented by the set of coordinates KB1 prime, KB2 prime, KB3 prime, it follows that if we choose the latter values for the coordinates of the base point B prime to the value lambda equal 1 will correspond the value mu equal 1, and hence we have always mu equal to lambda. In other words, we have Corollary 4. If two distinct one-dimensional forms are projective, the base elements may be so chosen that the parameters of any two homologous elements are equal. Before closing this section, it seems desirable to call attention explicitly to the forms of the equation on any line of pencils and of the equation of any point of a pencil, which is implied by Theorem 5 prime and Theorem 5, respectively. If we place m equal to m1x1 plus m2x2 plus m3x3 and n equal to n1x1 plus n2x2 plus n3x3, it follows from the first theorem mentioned that the equation of any line of the pencil whose center is the intersection of the lines m equals 0, n equals 0 is given by an equation of the form m equal mu n equals 0. Similarly, the equation of any point on the line joining A equal to A1U1 plus A2U2 plus A3U3 equals 0 and B equal to B1U1 plus B2U2 plus B3U3 equal to 0 is of the form A plus lambda B equal to 0.
Projective Geometry, Volume 1. This book was written by Oswald Veblen and John Wesley Young. It was published by Blaisdell Publishing Company, London, 1910, and is now in the public domain. It is read by Jim Renholt, with programming and illustration by Jim Renholt, 2019. Thank you for listening.